but it is tough. So if anyone has any doubts that this is easy, try it yourself. It's about 5:15 a.m. that is. As you'll see, the sky is clear and the sun has been coming up. We've been listening to the dawn chorus. Now if you look ahead in the distance, you'll see a nasty range of hills. That's the next challenge and final challenge. I'm just coming to the end of 87 kilometres, just coming to the last stop. It's been very cold this evening. I actually now just want to finish it, as you would expect. But I'm pleased that I've got so far. But let's get to the whole way and I'll report back when I finished. So here's the view from halfway up Ditchling Beacon. It's pretty spectacular. And if I try and zoom in, you can see, I hope, some parked vehicles. I'm not very good at focusing on myself. There we are. There's a big motorhome down there. There's mine. There it is. Anyway, there you go. Big, quite a view. Very, very tough climb. Well, I'm coming, quite literally, coming up the final furlong or so to the end. I've just clocked over 64 miles, thinking the event was only 60 miles, 100 kilometres, but maybe my conversion rate is not terribly good. So there's the race course, as you can see, just on the outer fencing, and soon I shall go through the finish and I'll capture that as a little treat for you all, hopefully. Well, viewers, just a few thoughts about the event as I come into the home straight. Why did I do it? Well, it was there to be done, I suppose, and I never generally shirk a challenge. Would I do it again? Absolutely not. I don't tend to say never, but I do tend to say never again. But with this, I've done it. I shall no doubt go and buy the t-shirt. I've completed it. I would have nothing to prove if I did it again. Did I enjoy it? Aspects of it, yes. It was deeply tough. And it plumbed the depths of my resolve, my mental, physical and emotional side. But the results are there, hopefully, to be seen. And why have I done it, as I said at the beginning? Well, primarily for myself. I want to prove something. It's always nice to be able to do that. And of course, without being sounding too pious, I've done it for Brainwave. Nearly there. I always finish these things in a bit of an emotional state. This is no different, but I'm very pleased and proud of what I've done. So I'll sign off as I go through the finish line and say thank you for reading my blog and for watching this, if you have been able to get through it all, because God knows what it's like. I apologise for the terrible camera work and the ridiculous things I've said. But here we go. That's the time over there. Cheerleaders, they're not for me, alas. No, they are cheering for me. They are cheering for me. So here we go. There's the first one. So goodbye and thanks for watching.